Long before the start of formal education, babies are learning. In fact, literacy begins at birth. From day one, parents are their child's first teacher, and home really is their first school. Read to Grow is a local organization that distributes 100,000 free books each year to families in Connecticut, and they believe you can truly change a child's life with a book. Joining me now is Suzanne Santangelo, the executive director at Read to Grow, and Rosalie Carr, a teacher at Fairhaven School. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here. Well, Suzanne, let's talk about the fact that why is it so important for parents to read out loud to their babies and toddlers?
Mm-hmm. Well, Read to Grow is the only statewide organization that starts building literacy right from birth. And we do so because science tells us that babies are born learning, and that the first 3 years are critical in terms of how the baby's brain develops and how they get ready for language and later reading. So parents, those first 3 years are really important to start reading aloud to baby. So when you're reading aloud, they're hearing your voice, they're getting the rhythm of language, and that all those activities are stimulating the brain and the language and building a foundation for learning.
Well, there are some parents who are actually reading to their babies while the baby's in the womb.
There are. In fact, I talked to an about-to-be father recently who told me he was reading at night, same time, every night. And so that baby will recognize the voice
when the baby's born. So there is a benefit to doing that?
Absolutely. And think of the attachment that dad's already attaching to that baby.
By reading these books to the babies and toddlers, you really do have this attachment, and you do create a bond early in life.
Right. Think about when you're reading to a baby. You're holding your arms around the baby. You're creating memories. They're listening to your voice, the sound of your voice, the rhythm of the language. Those are memories that will be stored forever.
Rosalie, let's talk about what you see in the classroom. Can you tell the difference when a child has been read at home versus who has not?
Absolutely. When kids come to school that have been read to, they have an understanding of how to handle a book. They know the front of the book, the back of the book, things that are really important. And also, they have great background knowledge. So if I'm teaching something, a lesson about the farm, they'll know what a cow is or a pig. If they don't have that background knowledge, it makes it that much harder for them. It's just nice for them to feel successful in school right away.
So what happens to a child who hasn't been really read to as a youngster?
You know, we need to start at the beginning. I need to teach them about a book. I need to teach them about where's the front of the book, where's the back of the book, where are the words, where do you start reading, which way do you go, left to
so
right.
So it really puts them at a disadvantage.
Absolutely. I said I have to play catch up a little bit. So,
but do they eventually do catch up?
They do. Absolutely. They love to read it. They get so excited with a book. It's the first place they want to go when they get to school. They want to get a book. And when they get books, and if they can take them home, they're very excited.
I love to read
excited.
Children, especially
very
these school-age kids. Now, for those who do not know how to read to mm-hmm. their child, how would you advise a parent to do so?
I say to parents, the best thing that you can do for your child, read every day. And when you're reading the book, talk about the book. Look at the pictures, talk, make connections. What would you do if you were this character? How do you think you would feel?
Ask them questions. Get them to interact.
Look at the pictures. Talk about what you see in the pictures. This is how they get that background knowledge. This is a pig. Oh, this is, look at the pig. He has a curly tail. Those are the kinds of things that you can tell your kids when you're reading a book. And then they bring all that great information to school, and then I can build on it. So it's great.
So the most important here is that the children really do absorb what's going on in the book.
Absolutely.
All right.
Yeah.
Suzanne, let's talk about two programs mm-hmm. that Read to Grow has, and that is the Books for Kids program. Mm-hmm.
Our Books for Kids program is a program that gives free books to children statewide from birth all the way through high school. And these are books that are donated to Read to Grow either from publishers or a local community might decide to do a book drive, hold a book drive. And as you said, we distributed over 100,000 books last year.
And this was actually made possible by a grant.
Well, we have many grants, but we worked with the Fairhaven Elementary School mm-hmm. recently through a generous grant from Comcast Foundation. And we will, through that grant, be able to distribute about 10,000 new and used books to the New Haven community.
You also have a upcoming book drive. Tell us more about that.
RBS has very generously sponsored a book day for Read to Grow at the Bridgeport Bluefish Game on August 29th at 2 o'clock. So come, bring a new book or a used book.
And do they come in free for the game?
No, they don't come in free, but
okay.
They can bring a book, donate a book to Read to Grow.
And it's all going to the children in the Bridgeport area, or is that all throughout the state?
Statewide.
It is statewide. And what about these books, though, that the children will be reading specifically? Are these books that they need to have specific subjects, or it can be any kind of book that somebody can bring in?
It can be any kind of book as long as it's in pretty good condition, or they can purchase a new book. But everything from a board book for newborns and very young ones to chapter books for older students.
When a parent is trying to choose a book for, let's say, a baby or a toddler to get them going, what should they be looking for?
Well, I'll use the example of Baby Day.
This is a great book. We love this book.
We love this book.
We love the author.
This is a book by Nancy Elizabeth Wallace, a local author, and this book is distributed through our Books for Babies program. That's a program that gives every newborn in the hospital this book before they leave, and then they give a guide to their parents that really helps them to understand how they're building their baby's language development. And so you can see it's a good, sturdy book with bright colors. You want a lot of distinction in colors for young ones.
So you shouldn't be too worried about the words itself, because obviously these children do not know how to read yet, but you want to keep it simple.
They're simple words. You might even have a book that has no words that you can elaborate. You can tell a story in the book. And for families where they're a little nervous about their reading ability, you can tell a story and make up a story by looking at the pictures.
And Rosalie, what about you from a teacher's perspective when you see these kids light up? It's just amazing, isn't it?
Oh, my word. We were so fortunate when Comcast came to our school with Read to Grow, and every student in the school got a book. So we watched. They were walking to the classroom downstairs with reading the book. And my little ones, I have kindergarten, they were, do I have to bring this back? No, this is your book forever. And they're so excited to have this book to take home. That's theirs forever. And our goal at school is to try to get them a new book or a book every month to take home so that they can start their home library. Because how nice to be able to get your book and read it again. And it's a treasure. It's a treasure.
Reading really just opens up a whole new world for children, doesn't
treasure.
It?
Treasure.
It does, and there are words in a book that you're not going to hear in everyday language. Mm-hmm. You talked about if you don't have the experience of living on a farm, well, a book opens that mm-hmm. world to you. It talks about giraffes and pigs and cows, and that's not something you're using in everyday language. So you're really increasing the child's vocabulary.
And if you want more information on Read to Grow, let's put the information right now on the screen. They're located in Brantford, or you can come to our website, and we'll have the information for you. Suzanne and Rosalie, thank you so much for being here.
Thank
really appreciate
us.
It.
Thank you.
You're